And once again, I am one technical difficulty later, and we are back! Ah, sorry about that, folks. Oh, technology can be a pain sometimes, especially when you're running out of disk space. Anyway, hey, let's zoom. 3, 2, 1, go! Even laugh!
Is it me or the Minotaur almost look like Beast from Beauty and the Beast?
No.
Nah. Hypocrite.
Okay, I'm gonna say it. Oh shit. Here we go again. Alright, that's fine.
Hey guys, check it out. Icarus wiped out.
Yep.
So they're just going to ignore the ominous laughter and just go back to conversing.
Yeah.
This is the most unrealistic. This most unrealistic. Actually, no way. Hold the helmet, King. Normal teenager would act this way too.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Which, by the way, DL, this is actually the only footage that they used from an episode of season one.
Really?
The rest of the footage that they used in this film, that they used in the movie. All from the first three episodes of season two.
Wow. You got a point.
Yeah.
Yes!
Yes!
Hey guys, check it out! Heads are rolling!
God damn it.
Damn it!
Oh, crap!
Oh, no!
It's alright, I'm certain Athena has assurance.
Aphrodite.
I'm sorry, I'm sure Aphrodite has insurance. Maybe. Do gods have insurance?
Possibly.
The way he yelled "get out" is just out of nowhere. It's
Those are piss poor.
It's the most easily avoidable or counterable version of a batarang ever.
Yep.
Yeah.
No. It's a lamerang.
Ooh.
I will say, hey, Michael Dorn does a fantastic evil villain laugh.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh no, Hercules mad! Hercules smash! Ooh. Frank Welker to the rescue.
Come on.
Seriously, there's no time to monologue.
Temple Road.
So basically, you're saying, Hercules, we need a plan of attack.
I have a plan. Attack.
Attack.
well done, gentlemen. Two sweets all around.
Too sweet. Ooh.
So, does that mean my blockbuster joke?
Oh, Herc, no.
Wasn't picked up. Deal.
Huh?
So my blockbuster joke wasn't picked up. Okay.
I will say it's kind of awesome we're seeing Hercules actually given to his rage for once.
No,
yeah.
Right?
Ooh. Use your head!
Am I literally seeing this? Hercules is literally knocking out a whole block.
Of course.
Oh! Gee.
You could save 15% or more on building insurance.
Also, Aflac!
I was thinking
that works too.
Why do you hate Labyrinth? That's a fantastic movie.
Unless one dude is doing the magic dance.
No. Especially when a dude's doing the magic dance. Rule number one, if you're being detained by your enemies and either thinking about how to torture you or you, don't say what you hate the most. They're just gonna do it anyway.
Yeah.
I mean,
by the look of the cast, you don't really need someone's signature in the cast.
How the heck is he doing that? The cast is clearly made of cloth.
That's three times the Adonis got owned.
Adonis owned count. Three.
By the way. Hey Adonis, you play Pokemon? Think you need a burn heal.
Better have burn heal.
Okay, one more for the road.
Wah wah wah.
Bum bum ba-dum.
Also, you didn't see that coming?
Oh.
Oh boy.
Jeez. Are you seriously doing a diorama of the Earth? That
wait,
looks so
wait, flat. Wait. I get it now.
Yeah.
Because people back in the day thought that the Earth was
flat.
I didn't realize that before. Also, for those of you who think that the Earth is flat, in the words of Cell, we're good for you, you're wrong.
Exactly.
Seriously, there's scientific evidence to prove that the Earth is round. Mm-hmm. Christopher Columbus even proved this back in the day. Hey, we have satellites literally orbiting the planet that prove that the Earth is in fact round. So shut up!
Just give up already.
Anyway, back to the actual episode.
I'm getting hot blood.
Okay, query, how is that he's not getting in trouble? I'm pretty sure that if you have a project that can actually cause harm to your other students, that thing would basically cause a lot of trouble, but what do I know? I'm just a logical human being.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was before Mentos ever created.
Mentos, the fresh maker.
God dang it, RedRob. Did you know that a member of the Mythbusters crew actually came up with that?
What?
The Mentos and Coke experiment?
Did you know that a
member of the Mythbusters crew originally came up with that?
Which one? Dang it!
Yeah, Carrie.
Hey, nice. Corey Burton's not too bad as Zeus.
No, not at all.
He's not that bad.
I mean, he got better. I mean, his Zeus voice is better in the God of War games, but.
I mean, he's no Rip Torn, but he'll be doing a pinch.
Oh yeah.
But don't let anyone your secret that you're angry. No, that you're always angry.
God damn it, RedRob.
God damn it, RedRob.
Referencing Kronos. Whoa.
Oh God! Put the pants on! Okay. Query, how the heck did Zeus even get into that school?
I have no idea.
I'm on the bed, I know.
God powers.
Yeah. Makes sense.
Hey, James Woods.
Oh, yes, the real star of the show. Took you long enough.
Yeah,
that's the one problem I will say with this movie. It's the fact that there's not enough James Woods.
Yeah.
I mean, I understand they can include certain episodes in this, but come on, at least include two with James Woods in them.
Yeah.
Not much to agree about that.
Wait, objective what?
Whoa.
I didn't hear...
Puppy Cerberus!
Ooh!
They put it his way by licking him. That's adorable.
Yeah.
Oh, what?
And yes, especially Hades, Pain and Panic do have their original voice actors from the film or from the movie reprising their role.
Canonically, the idea of owning Cerberus was Pain and Panic's idea. It's just they're so terrible their job, Hades ended up being the one to raise it.
Wow.
Yeah. I bet some pet owners could actually relate to that.
Ah! I love the fact that Fizz Oedipus. Not only is voiced by Richard Simmons, but the fact that his hair looks very similar to Richard Simmons.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Where did you notice that?
All he's missing is the red hair.
Yep.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is it me, or does this remind me of the live-action film Dodgeball?
Eh, somewhat.
If you dodge a wrench, you dodge a ball.
Which is funny, considering that one was in that movie.
Oh.
Ow! Oh, yeah.
But he can't even, he throw his own ball and won't count.
And it's ironic that they're in phys ed, because Adonis is about to get schooled.
Yeah.
Yep.
This is just being catch this. Ooh.
God.
Zach, really?
Well,
but to be fair, Zach did appear in the Kingdom Hearts games, but it doesn't look like his dad.
Oh my god, just checked. Apparently the thing is, Fizz Oedipus has actually appeared in two other episodes of the Hercules series.
Really?
Oh, which ones?
Really? Hercules and the big games, and Hercules and the hostage crisis.
Oh, dear.
Oh my god.
Huh.
Oh, oh, you idiot!
Ooh, this! Oh, come on! Why have to mess with the eyeball?
Ah, the fates. Sadly, only one of them was able to reprise their role.
Oh, which one?
Atropos.
Huh. Ironic, the only one
and
we don't
have. Sadly, this would be one of the last times she would get to reprise her role before she passed away, before her voice actor passed away in October of 1999.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's gone our heart.
Wait, so which fate was she?
Atropos.
Oh, hold on. Okay, actually, I'm checking for, there were two fates whose roles were reprised.
Oh?
Let's... Lachesis?
Oh, Lachesis and Atropos?
Lachesis is voiced by her same actress from the movie.
Hmm.
Ah.
Carol Shelley, I believe it is.
Carol Shelley.
Ah.
And, weirdly enough,
Clotho does not have any lines in the movie at all.
But,
wow.
But
that's weird.
Yeah. And, well, no. She does have lines. It's the third one that doesn't. The one with only one, with only like one eye.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Now, the thing is, while I'm pretty sure it's not her same, or this isn't the voice actress she had in the movie, her voice actress is the voice actress for Clotho. Oh, it is actually someone we're familiar with.
Oh,
Triss McNeely.
Triss McNeil.
Nine.
Dot.
Yes.
Rita the Cat.
Oh.
Okay, that's amazing.
And also current the most the most current voice of Daisy Duck.
Yep.
Ah.
Well, I will say this actually did a really good job.
Well, I'll be.
Ah. No. Bah, 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 bah.
Anyway.
I thought it's exactly Hades. It's funny how Hades didn't recognize his brother, but he actually caught on.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this is exactly why that was a bad idea.
Uh-oh.
Boy, that was quick.
You got it coming.
Mm-hmm.
He had it coming.
No.
No.
I'm sorry, is there anything I hear that? Oh boy, Hera's gonna be. Well.
Yeah.
Hera will be like, I felt disturbance in the force.
Yeah.
Yep.
Zushi should have think things through.
Thank you. Oh!
Are you kidding me?
Ooh. Poor Zeus! Fuck! Wait, Athena?
Yeah.
Basically one of his daughters.
Oh, I know. Well, it is tough to be a god.
To tread where mortals have not trod. Also, in the case, in the words of Apu, ha! Now you know how it feels!
You know how it feels!
Oh, wait. Oh, crap.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck.
Well, at least one head understands you.
Also, James Woods must have been having the time of his life recording every episode of this show.
Yep. Also,
I can see that.
Well, this line's Rogue Lovers. Muslim boy.
Oh.
Oof.
Excuse me. Now Zeus is realizing the big flaw in his plan.
Hold on. I have a button for this.
Oh,
I believe that this clip works perfectly in this case when it comes to Zeus.
All right. It was at this moment that he knew.
Yep.
Yeah.
Not much to say with that clip alone.
Also,
bravely ran away. God, Hades! Such an entertaining villain!
Well, what about your other brother Poseidon, Hades?
Oh my god!
Bad doggy!
Yeah. No shit! Boyish impetuosity? What?
Also, that's not a word. That never has been a word.
No.
You mean animosity?
No,
impetuosity. What he said.
Oh, all right. And since Herc knows the truth, now it's time for a real father-son bonding.
Actually, DL, it is a word.
What?
Yeah.
Well, you kind of lose scramble.
Oh, wait, hold on. Is this supposed to be the same lullaby he sang to Hercules?
I think.
Huh. Interesting.
I will say this about Corey. He has a hell of a singing voice.
Not bad.
Oh, yeah.
Aw.
Oh!
That's...
Oh, wow. That's
the lullaby that Alcmene sang to Hercules.
Wow, that is some great continuity.
Yep. Oh, absolutely.
It's brilliant.
Aww. I see families in conflict.
Ooh.
Strike!
Fucking bowling pin sound effect.
Oh my.
Uh-oh.
Not good for Hades. They fucked with him! They fucked with him! Oh my god, I love that! I love
that! He's Hades.
Oh my god!
Bitch.
No. What happened was, they sealed his fate!
Favorite DL, I can't be mad at that!
Thank you!
Bravo, DL!
Oh, this is gonna...
Wait, hold on. You know what's gonna happen right now? Hades' fate is about to start at zero.
Ah, oh, dang it.
Hades? Okay. The elf just got fucked up button. Hey ho!
Oh. Wait, did he seriously make a dad joke?
What do you expect? Heck, he technically is a dad!
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Wearing a smite me sign.
Wow. I won't lie, that was very satisfying.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes.
In fact, let's see it again real quick.
Yes, please. Huh. Susan is still amazing as always.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I also appreciate the fact that this song basically shows that, yeah, she knows what he used to be like, but she doesn't care.
Yeah.
Oh, I remember that episode.
Oh, the Nemean lion!
No. Ooh. This episode is where this guy was trying to impersonate Zeus. And
wow.
Inadvertently pissed him off. And when Herc revealed that he was the son of Zeus, that the real Zeus basically banished him to some sort of world.
Hmm.
And he then came up with the idea to basically have Pain and Panic become a lion.
What the hell? What?
That's it?
Wait. Hold on. Hold it. Not so fast. I have a plan B. Don't worry. All right. So we will not hear the end of the song, but we can at least see the end of the movie.
All right.
Okay. Nicely but done which, on the plan B.
Which, thank you very much. Much kiss cartoon. Ugh. Anyway. Anyway, alright, so. Someone did actually take some of the scenes with Meg from the movie and compile. Hold on. This is the last scene.
Good.
And we at least get to hear the last few notes of the song.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh no!
Oh god!
Oh, you're being cruel.
Hey, don't not cheerleader. Cheerleader usually hot in high school.
Oh yeah, I can still imagine Meg being a cheerleader.
Five bucks says they're still he'll has a fan of that somewhere.
I wouldn't be dead surprised.
All right. So we still have one, possibly two more episodes to cover, but let's cover the movie itself real quick. So that was Hercules Zero to Hero. Honestly, I don't really think this movie gets enough credit. Okay.
Agreed.
Okay. I know that on the surface, yes, this is a glorified compilation of about three episodes of the...
Of about four episodes.
Technically...
Please. Actually, DL, apparently there's an extra episode featuring Helen of Troy.
No, there wasn't.
Oh.
There was only three episodes. I don't know. I don't know where you heard that, but...
That may have been me, because I had the wiki. I had the regular wiki up.
Oh, so it must be the wiki that was wrong.
Yeah, because... Yeah. Like
I guess so.
Okay.
But now, again, I know that to many people, they will brush us off as just, oh, it's just a compilation of episodes. And, okay, yeah, you're right. It is that. But when you look under the surface, there is a little more to this. Because if you... Okay, so let's pretend that, say, this wasn't part of a series. Let's just say this was a series of mini-adventures that basically was meant to tell about Hercules' teenage life. When you look at it from that perspective, the movie not only did well in telling those stories and picked some decent ones, but in the end, they all served a purpose.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. And when you think about it, it showed three aspects when it came to Hercules. Please, how much he could be a loser in high school, or how destructive he could be. It'd be, and also, how miserable high school was for him at times.
Mm-hmm.
Which, let's be fair here, when you're telling someone about your high school life, those are kind of the main beats you want to hit on, mm-hmm. even if yeah. you don't want to.
Yeah.
And honestly, I feel that they picked some decent episodes. Would I have preferred if they picked more episodes with Hades? Absolutely. But I'm pretty sure all of us would have preferred that. But I give them credit for giving us a nice diverse number of episodes. And each of them focused on a completely different adversary.
Mm-hmm. That's
honestly something you have to give this credit for.
Yeah.
And I also like
yes, you can write this movie off as being formulaic, but honestly, I don't see it as that.
Here's the thing.
Neither do I.
I know that this is, at the end of the day, a compilation and film. And, yeah, it is, but here's the thing. Compilation films aren't exactly a bad thing, per se. I feel as long as there's something, a narrative tying them all together, then it's fine.
I mean,
besides, there are other Disney movies that have had less than successful compilation and films. Tarzan and Jane!
Oh, no. The worst one happens to be Belle's Magical World. Believe me, don't watch it.
Fair, okay. Let me be fair. Ones were an actual series that existed.
Shameless cash grabs.
But I honestly do kind of like the framing device of the movie. It's nice to see what Meg and Hercules were doing after the credits rolled. I mean, let's be honest here. How often, when it comes to Disney films, do we actually focus on this, on what happens in Happily Ever After, other than crappy sequels?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And honestly, to me, the thing that really ties together is the little musical number at the end with Meg, where she basically says that, yeah, she knows that Hercules could be was a dork in high school. Yeah, she knows that at times he could be a loser. And hell, she knows that his life in high school was miserable. Mm-hmm. Thanks to those stories. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, she does not care. She still loves him.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And when you remember the fact that they're married, that makes perfect sense. And hell, the thing is, when it comes to a marriage and such, talking about your embarrassing in life as a teenager and such, that's kind of exactly when those talks come up.
Yeah,
pretty much. I mean, it now, could obviously be happened to anyone.
Yeah. Well, now, will I say this movie is perfect? Oh god, no. Absolutely not. The animation is fucking dated as shit. Mm-hmm. Yet, and because of the fact that it hasn't had a proper re-release, the quality of the actual film itself, it is not up to snuff.
No.
Absolutely not. I will say this. If you want to have some proper closure when it comes to the first Hercules movie, and you're willing to sit through some less than stellar animation, and I recommend at least giving this movie a shot. At least watch it once. Yeah, I feel it's worth giving at least one watch because... at the end of the day... here's the thing. When it comes to certain compilations and films Disney did for their shows, there didn't really feel like there was any sort of point to it. Like, why are we talking about this? Zero to Hero, however, does not fall into that trap. There is a purpose behind these clips. There is a reason why we're talking about this.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Is it a little forced? Maybe, but at least there's a real reason for why we're seeing the things that we are. Hmm. And yeah, I know some episodes are out of order, but let's be fair, but here's the thing. When it comes to the Hercules series, say for one or two episodes, most episodes are pretty standalone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's not too much of an issue. And the fact that you couldn't even notice in this little compilation film kind of emphasizes my point. Overall, I give this B+.
Yeah. Solid B from me.
Yeah, let's go with a solid B. It'd be this is not what I would call an underrated gem per se. If I can use one word for it, it would be underappreciated.
Because
the thing is, here's the thing. Back in the day, I was a huge fan of Hercules. I loved the movies. So this not only succeeded in giving me some closure on the first movie, but it told me, oh hey, there's a series I can watch now. Cool.
Mm-hmm. It's like with me. I mean, like with the Aladdin series. I loved the Aladdin movie, and I love the fact that the series continues, the adventure that Aladdin has, and not only that, it also gave Aladdin a lot more to deal with.
Well, it's not really the same thing, but I can get where you're coming from.
It's not really the same thing because they had a backdoor pilot movie with Return of Jafar.
Where they didn't really have a real compilation film like Zero to Hero here.
Fair.
Overall, this isn't admittedly somewhat enjoyable old film. It'll be difficult for you to track down how to download for but I think it's at least worth it. I mean, hell, it can't be all bad. You got at least half of the cast from the movie reprising their roles. I mean, okay. One thing I appreciate that they actually did in both the series is the fact that they had Tate Donovan voicing Hercules for at least the whole time. Don't get me wrong. I have nothing against Josh Heaton. Nothing at all against Josh Heaton.
Zilch.
But the fact that the same character voices all of his, well, how should I put it, points in life really does help emphasize that, yeah, this is the same guy.
Mm-hmm.
Now, do I think that Tate should be voicing him in all incarnations in the future? No, I still feel Josh King should still be able to voice him as a teenager, especially in stuff like Kingdom Hearts and such like that. But in terms of adult Hercules, absolutely.
Yeah.
I just think it was nice that Tate got to voice this version of Hercules that's not really as impressive or powerful as the original. And let's be fair, and honestly, I kind of appreciate that we had a series about Hercules basically learning how to be a hero. How we saw him struggle and such like that. It's, well, for lack of a term, it humanizes him.
Mm-hmm.
Now, is every adventure great? Absolutely not. No. But I feel that the series at least made this character feel less like a stereotype and more like a proper fleshed out character.
Oh yeah.
Especially the writing is always go on for laughs.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
But we're not quite done. We got the
animated series.
Yeah. So here's what we're gonna do. We're going to, before we look at the certain episode we all are here to see. I have an idea.
Oh.
All right. Mm-hmm. So first, what I'm going to do is going to pull up the actual series,
which is thankfully available in its entirety on Disney Plus.
Also,
yes.
Flutter, there was only one season.
Really?
Says so on Disney Plus. Only one season.
Weird. Well, Wikipedia only lists 13 episodes per season 2.
What they probably did was basically
include those episodes as part of.
There's at least 65 episodes total, and oh good lord, it says here that. Here, the Hercules and the Green Adventure was episode 62.
Damn.
Oh, wow.
All right, so. Wait, hold on, what? Okay, Flutter.
What's going on?
So, give me a moment, gentlemen, I need to look at this.
Oh boy.
We might have to take back some of the stuff one of the nice things we said about Zero to Hero.
Why?
Because it turns out, Sentai, you were actually right. This does adapt 4 episodes.
Because here's the thing,
the bits with Meg and Hercules, even such, are from an episode called Hercules and the Yearbook.
Huh.
Oh.
So...
And... Okay, so it essentially... Okay, yeah, I see.
40, yeah, episode 47 of season 1, according to the wiki page.
Yeah.
So... Oh, they basically we took this and combined all the episodes into one?
Yeah.
Hell, there's an hell. They even adapted an earlier episode.
Okay, you know what? Oh, I was going to do a randomize, to determine what episode we look at before we look at the real one we came here for. But screw it. But screw it. We're gonna see what this episode was actually supposed to be like. Here we go.
All right.
Oh, hold on. Let's check for language. There we go. Why does it keep doing that?
I don't know. But yeah, then they... Yeah. So, never mind. Yeah, they adapted two episodes from season one and three episodes from season two.
Yep.
Yeah, DL, here's the thing. They adapted the first... They also adapted the first three episodes of season two.
Ah...
Oh, by the way, in the movie, the film, the narrator, Charlton Heston.
Oh,
he returned to do that? Oh, nice.
Well...
This is what I get for not doing my fucking research on this damn thing.
It's fine. We're not all perfect.
Yeah.
I know, but it's still frustrating.
Fair.
Well, at least now we can see it in proper quality.
Yeah, and with subtitles.
Yay!
Yeah.
I'm gonna say this. I thought the All Might had kind of an ego. Raising.
No. Here's the thing. Erecting the monument. That's what happens in the bedroom.
Ooh.
Nicely done.
Thank you. Actually, here's a legitimate question. Why wasn't this used as the series finale?
You know.
This would have been perfect as a series finale.
Yeah, it would have. But
Thank you. If I can't give credit on one thing, regardless of where this came from, at least it's at least nice to see them properly acting like a married couple.
Mm-hmm. He would.
She did.
She would. She literally took a vehicle of yours and go towards another planet. Oh, that's the wrong series.
No. She did the typical thing a wife would do. Took the man's car without permission to do it was something she wanted. See? You're already married.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm legitimately curious, Flutter, what's the production order exactly? Did Zero to Hero come out after the episodes were produced, or before?
Hold on. Release date.
Hit it, ladies.
Oh. Again, failure montage.
Also, okay, DL. Apparently, Zero to Hero was released in between the two seasons.
Oh.
Or actually, wait. Hold on. Hold on.
Also, I just realized that's the mother of all monsters from the Cyclops episode.
Yeah.
That's kidnap. Actually, DL? Zero was released about half a year after the series had ended.
What?
You're kidding.
Yeah.
So hold on. It was made to promote us. So why did they make it? Was it literally a quick buck thing?
Maybe.
Yes.
Also, again, legit question. Why is this not used as a series finale?
Yeah, I agree.
It's hard to see with an episode like Hercules and the Yearbook.
Oof.
Let's. Wait, hold on. Whoa! That wasn't in the movie?
Yeah. Okay.
Wait a minute. Did they actually animate some new scenes for Zero to Hero when it came to that?
I think so.
Yes.
Either that or they added some stuff out.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Buckus.
Oh yeah, that's from Don Louise.
I love the bit with Hades. That was hilarious.
Oh yeah.
We all have good. Well, Tom's always. May you rest in peace, you beautiful man. Oh my god, I love Tom's always.
He is a very good voice actor.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, dude, I freaking loved him Secret of Nim, and of course, in American Tail.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. His performance in Secret of Nim was amazing.
I mean, hell, it's Pizza the Hut.
And
I forgot about that.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
Oh, fuck. Poseidon.
Now, who voiced him?
Hold on. I know exactly who did it. Hit it. Keep the noise down, Jerry!
Wow.
That's Dorks.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my
Jesus,
God.
This dude's hopeless.
Oh my God.
Oh my fucking God, Icarus.
If you're referencing Pirates of the Caribbean, you know your butt's gonna get kicked.
No, he isn't.
No.
I mean you could look at it that way, but oh Jesus.
Oh,
oh
dude.
Good Lord.
Ugh.
Take a hit!
Icarus, you have no idea, dude.
The Oracle Friends Network?
Yes.
That's actually clever.
What the?
What the fuck?
A sheep?
Oh, she got the balls.
Oh,
really?
To be fair, yeah, that happened the moment he chose to marry her.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wait, hold on a sec. Give me a sec. Give me a moment. I'm gonna do some research real quick.
Okay.
I'm going to determine something right now to see how much effort was actually put into that movie.
I thought that voice sounded familiar.
Alright, let's see here.
Sorry about that, it's just...
I know. Okay, let's see here. Take a look, see. All right.
Oh,
All right, there's the playlist. Give me a moment.
Oh!
Wait a sec. Okay, I was wrong. There was no... They only edited a few things out for Zero to Hero. Because take a look at this scene from the movie!
Huh.
They didn't even edit out the sheep face thing!
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Wow.
Okay, fuck it, I take it... Okay, fuck it, I take it back. This thing gets a D.
Yeah.
You take it all back?
Okay, I'm gonna... This may be hard to say this, but... Digimon the movie had more production value than Zero to Hero. Yes, I fucking said that.
Well, so much for the hero, the great hero he was in this movie. But let's just be real here. The original will always be the original.
Yeah. But you know what? We're not quite done. So
let's just continue on.
Yes.
Actually, hold on. I know exactly what we'll do real quick. I'm gonna stop the record. No. Actually, we'll keep it because what we're gonna do is gonna do what is we are still gonna keep the thing we keep. I'm gonna basically find a way to do some editing. I think I'm gonna see if I can actually find out how to properly edit the video itself. Elf.
I guess you're gonna ask your dad how to do that.
Yes, that's the idea. Yeah. Basically, I'm going to edit it out, which hopefully I'll be able to properly do with this video, and the audience will not hear this. So, I'm going to try and edit out the stuff with our original thoughts on Zero to Hero. Oh, and then, am I being too harsh, though?
No!
Yeah, you're right. I am not being too harsh.
Yeah. Anyway, continuing on.
Probably also edit out the part where you bring this up, you know?
That is the idea.
Euro World?
Hi, Eric Idle, and...
Euro!
Oh, he's got a...
Fucking
Euro?
We got
a job to spell Euro.
What?
You're kidding.
Wait.
Well, I know that...
Oh, my
Wait. Hold on. Actually, you know what? We don't have to take... Hey, about what we said, because... Okay, looking back, there actually were some new things they included in, like the introduction for the Minotaur, and also the whole thing with Zeus. So there was actually some production value put into the movie. Not much, but some.
Well, I more attribute that to those being later episodes.
No. Here's the thing. Flutter. Hercules basically introduced the story when it came to the Minotaur and Zeus. Given I'm scrolling through this, that was newly animated footage, as well as new recorded lines.
Huh.
All right, we'll put it at a C, but no higher.
Yeah. Yeah, right. I agree.
Anyway.
Oh my fucking god. That's the hat that he wore during that internship.
I also recognize the voice. The owner?
Really?
Yeah.
That was
Yo!
Hell yeah!
You Keith! Apollo's chariot?
Also, we got Keith David up in this bitch! Hell. Oh, here we go.
Of course they're riding harpies.
Of course.
Quick! Someone had three harpy feather duster!
God fucking damn it, DL.
It worked too well. You can't be mad at him, Flutter.
It's hard to not get mad at DL for making a harpy reference in Yu-Gi-Oh.
You are!
Oh, fuck. In case of insurgency, break glass. In emergency, lightning bolts.
I know.
What? Wait a minute, that was a shot in the opening!
Oh, yeah!
Oh!
There's no way anyone could eat something like
this. Oh, dear.
Galatea.
Oh, I remembered that.
The Aphrodite dance.
Get it?
Yeah. Wait. What?
No, Icarus.
No, no. Please tell me, Hercules. You didn't.
He did.
What the fuck?
You made a homunculus?
Teenager.
He made a homunculus just so he'd have a date. Gentlemen, facepalm in 3, 2, 1.
Actually, one moment.
Uh oh.
Hold on. There's gotta be a button for it, don't it?
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna give. Okay, fuck it. I'm gonna bump Zero here up a little bit more. At least they didn't show us this.
Fair.
This is not right.
No.
Oh my god, I can hear Phoebe in that voice.
Yeah.
My god.
Yeah, that's Lisa Kudrow voicing Aphrodite.
You may remember her from Dr. Doolittle 2 as Ava.
That's true too.
She was also in Rock Walker.
Okay. That okay. I'll admit that's the most realistic thing a teenager could ask in this situation.
Yeah. Was in the second Boss Baby movie.
Huh.
Yeah.
No! Oh, you fool!
No! What? What? What did you say?
He said, make her crazy about me. Do you want yandere's? That's how you get yandere's.
Oh my god.
Have you never heard of the saying, don't stick your dick in crazy?
No, you fool. You're going to regret this. Or in the words of Looney Tunes, you'll be sorry! Also,
that's a good one.
Also,
wait, Galatea, but she's not a clone Supergirl.
Also, oh, really?
Sentai, get out. Get the fuck out!
Hold up. Flutter, we are adults. We should handle this rationally. However, I am petty as shit, so...
Swiggity Swaggo Realm, say hello to the Shadow Realm.
You're banished!
Seriously, also, fucking Supergirl reference?
Justice League Unlimited.
Oh, God.
Justice League Unlimited reference? What the fuck?
Also, really, Herc? Of all colors to pick, you went for a redhead? Wait.
What's wrong with redheads?
Actually, given he ended up embering Meg, that actually makes more sense when you think about it.
Yeah, it does.
And you will regret it very much.
Yes.
Oh, dude, Icarus.
Oh, hi, Helen of Troy. Voiced by Ariel herself, Jodie Benson.
Wait, really?
Yes.
Yeah.
No way.
There's a Disney princess in this series.
Holy shit, that's awesome. What the? And who has joined us suddenly?
Welcome back, Sentai.
All right, Sentai. I almost forgot about him. Wait.
Enough to send him back from the Shadow Realm.
Wait, hold on. So, she's a girl that basically threatens bimbos, and also beats the shit out of bullies. I'm starting to find less issues with this.
Yeah.
A bit.
Hold on. Okay, let's check here. Who actually voices Galatea?
I got it.
Hercules and the Year...
DL Sentai's already looking it up.
Yeah, I got it. We hit characters. Let's see.
Excuse me.
Galatea.
Oh my fucking god!
Where is she?
Oh, wait, hold on. I see. Okay, so apparently this thing is the yearbook. Hercules in the Yearbook is actually technically also a compilation. It's a compilation of at least three other episodes. Hercules in the Bacha. And all Hercules and the Apollo mission,
and
Hercules and the Dream Date.
By the way, DL Galatea,
that's Jennifer Aniston. Wait! Hold up.
Wait.
We have Phoebe from Friends creating Annie Rachel. What?
Wait, Jennifer Aniston is voiced.
Yes! Yes, it's Jennifer Aniston!
Holy hell?
Oh, I remember her as Annie Hughes from the Iron Giant.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
By the way, we need to riff that movie.
Yes.
Don't be a Gorgon, girl.
What's the matter, Hurt? This is what you wanted.
Thank you, Cassandra.
Terminator reference, I love it.
Come
with me if you want to live.
Uh-oh. Fucking Terminator reference.
There was two of them. She reformed like the T-1. He's a fucking Sandman.
Christ, she's been creepy.
Actually, no, you know what she Rachel? Is?
Rachel, please go back to Ross.
Lose Wonder Boy and go back to Ross.
I know you guys are on break, but please go back to Ross.
Here we go. Oh dear.
Oh fuck.
Graduation day can be a lot more awkward than it seems to be.
Okay.
There's a little shop market. Okay. Oh my fucking god! He risks being late for the graduation ceremony.
Why not?
By having...
Wait, what?
Adonis is one credit short of graduation, Sentai.
So he has to attend summer school. Oh, that is so satisfying.
Yes.
All I'm going to say is this. Loser!
Oh crap.
No. Oh fuck.
Damn it, Hulk!
Oh, Hercules!
Damn it, Hercules!
Oh no.
Jeez.
Well, please, there's one.
Well,
please stop.
Well, at least got one hell of a throwing arm.
Yeah. So that explains that line.
Yeah. At least we get to hear the whole song now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Let's yes.
See different scenes.
Wait. Oh. Okay, so all are the same clips.
Almost exact?
Yeah, they're pretty much... Almost the exact same clips.
Almost.
There's a few things in here that weren't...
Like that?
Or that? Like that? I mean, also.
That.
Wait, was he fighting a manticore?
I think he was.
He was, actually.
Is that a ninja?
Wait.
Ninjas?
Is that
Atlas? Ninjas don't exist in Greece.
Hydra is the lion that was being in panic. Mm-hmm.
That definitely wasn't in the movie.
Yes, it was.
No, that bit wasn't. The bit where he grabbed the lion? No, that was not.
Huh.
Okay, those weren't there either.
Can I give a minute to acknowledge that and that Susan Egan is such a great singer that
really
she ends
is.
Up being that she ends up being in a voice of Steven Universe as Pink Diamond.
Oh, nice.
Really?
Rose Diamond, yeah.
Huh.
Or Rose Quartz, actually.
Well, that too.
Remember, same person. Pink Diamond, Rose Quartz are the same.
Yeah.
That wasn't in there either, but her.
Oh.
Oh.
You're being cruel with her going not let him do it. Glee Club.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Thinking back. Okay. Yes. Technically, the film was when we thought it was, but let's be honest here. Here, at least the film felt like it was probably giving us an epilogue for this, for the movie. So maybe.
You were a little harsh.
Maybe we're a little harsh.
Maybe.
Yeah.
At the very least, let's give it a C+.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
But let's get to the real reason that we came here to see this episode. Let's see, this would be what was it, 58? What episode was this? Come on.
Where is it?
That would be episode. Ah! Oh, yeah, it was right. 58.
Yep.
Huh.
Excuse me.
Check out the language.
Let's see here. We're good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now then.
Ooh, okay. By the way, Sentai Chick newsroom for me real quick.
Ooh.
Is that a Zoid?
Like
yes.
Zero, baby.
Like
Zero.
Here we go.
And...
For full break.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, wow.
I'm sorry.
So wait, Ajax?
No, not that Ajax.
Wait. Is he doing this like a... Is he narrating like a noir story?
Yes.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
Don't go a great adventure on us, please.
Ah,
there's Hades.
The pool of forgetfulness.
Yep.
Good God. Yeah, Hades has got a point.
Of course.
Oh my god. God damn it, panic. Oh, hello!
Oh, hello.
Oh,
fear
no.
And terror.
They're jocks.
By the
oh,
way, you
God,
want to
oh, no.
Guys, you want to know who voices them?
Who?
Who are fear? David Cross.
David Cross?
Yep.
David Cross!
Yep.
As in... Arrested Development, David Cross.
And for terror, Toby Huss.
Huh.
What's his name again?
Tony.
Toby Huss. H-U-S-S.
Okay, Toby Huss. What did he...
You guys remember a show called The Adventures of Pete and Pete?
I've heard of it. I've never seen it.
He played a character called... Artie, the strongest man in the world.
In the world.
Yep, that's him.
But David Cross, that never crossed my mind.
They're fucking dude bros. Oh, Orpheus?
Oh, come on.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Orpheus as a rock star?
They're dude bros. Run!
So, did you say that these guys follow...
If I hear dude out of these two guys one more time, I'm gonna throw up.
By the way, I will say this. Did they... I will say this. At least in that... They must have learned the teachings from Iskandar.
Ares!
By the way, the voice for him?
Yeah.
Jay Thomas.
Who?
Oh, wow. Dave Jay Thomas.
Jay Thomas.
Jay Thomas.
I'm looking him up.
Let me see here.
Fudicles and Hidisco.
He was Paul Harris in The Love Boat.
Mm-hmm.
He was Eddie LeBlanc in Cheers.
found was the Easter Bunny in Santa Claus 2 and in Santa Claus 3.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
Hmm. Oh, so that explains the whole thing with the amphora. Mm-hmm. Mm. They all the amphorae all contain water from the pool of forgetfulness.
Hello?
Ah, oh. Their canonical first meeting.
And no surprise, her eyes make look just as attractive if as a teenager as she did as an adult.
Yes.
I hate to admit it, but she, yeah.
Call back!
Call forward!
Back, Flutter.
Well, no, remember. This takes place before the events of the film.
Fair.
Oh, speaking of the first film, Peter Griffin. She said it.
Oh, Adonis.
Oh, Adonis.
Yeah. Remember?
Okay.
Ex-boyfriend
thanks to that, there is heavy evidence, along with what we know happens at the end of this episode, that her ex-boyfriend was in fact Adonis. And given what we know about Adonis, that makes absolute sense and does not surprise me in the slightest that even though she basically, quote-unquote, gave her soul to ensure he lived, they ended up dumping her for someone he thought was hotter.
Yes.
Her. Shallow as fuck douchebag.
You are, to quote George Takei,
you are a douchebag. That's right. A douchebag. A total douchebag. Also, foreshadowing.
Yes.
Oh, of course.
And that explains her nickname.
Yep. Also, the thing is,
hero rules.
Also,
hero rules.
Remember, Phil actually went over her rule book and such.
Oh, right.
Definitely.
Wait, whoa. What? This cannot be real. This can't be real.
What is it?
In the Japanese dub for Kingdom Hearts 2 and 3, she was voiced by Rika Matsumoto!
What?
Dude!
Ash!
Yes! Look for yourself!
Nice.
Hold on.
Also,
well, I'll be darned.
Also, the thing is, this animation style actually does reveal a little thing about Meg that we didn't really notice when it came to the movie due to the lighting. She canonically has violet eyes.
Yeah.
Huh.
Oh, yeah.
Hold on.
Anyway.
Back to the show.
Oh my god, you're right.
So,
let's be fair here, the only reason he's not suspicious at all because he thinks she's hot, which...
And he's thinking with his other sword.
Yeah, so, yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
Hey, we know that voice.
I love it.
Hi, Brad.
Oh my god.
She is playing him like a fiddle.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, the world can be so ironic sometimes, candid boys.
Yeah. Yes.
Herc, shut up!
Shut it, you big lug.
Ah! Scarlet Wonder Boy! you couldn't see it, but I looked over at my Discord for a moment. With a quizzitive look, like,
What?
Get back here, pony boy. Flutter, what did you do?
No, I didn't do anything.
That's what they all say.
I'm being serious!
Yeah, we know, we're just fucking with you, dude.
I know, I'm playing along. Ooh, Centaur!
Hey, Jim Cummings!
Oh, yeah!
Huh.
Herc. She does not need protection.
No. Wait,
that's him.
Yeah, that's definitely Meg. That's definitely Jim. Yeah.
Hold on, isn't that the same centaur from the movie?
No, it's not. Hold on.
Hang on.
Wait, no. It's not the same design, but it's the same voice that... Wait, I get it now. It's another callback to the movie. The fact that he was working with a centaur in the movie, too, and now she's working with one here.
Yes, sir.
I guess he wants to get dangerous with her, if you know what I mean, and I think you do!
Yep.
I love the fact that Hercules always prefaces that whenever he brings up the fact that he's a hero.
Foreshadowing.
Yeah.
Well, Hercules, when it comes to that, I only have one quote to use in this situation. It's a quote from a very, very wise old man. lies old me. Old me. And if you'll give me a moment. Oh, Ben, if you please do the honors. Oh, God damn it.
Hold on.
Hit it again.
Ben, as in Ben Kenobi?
Yes, wait.
Before, yep.
Oh.
Who's the more foolish, the fool or the fool who follows him?
Aha!
You have to admit, that's a very valid point.
Oh, yeah. Hold on!
What?
He fucking sold it in to the Grecian equivalent of eBay? What the fuck?
Only in Disney.
Yeah.
Also, I find it weird that the subtitles are consistently spelling Aries like the constellation.
Meanwhile,
in the Temple of Aries. Also, wait, Aries. But he's not voiced by Steve Bloom.
God damn it.
DL RedRob for context. I'm making a God of War reference.
And I understood it.
I've heard of the God of War. I've heard of God of War games, but I haven't even played it.
Oh, they're fun.
Oh yeah, it's very cathartic too.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Oh God.
Have you chumps ever thought to think, and I know this is hard for you, that maybe if the water falls on him, he'll forget everything?
Fucking no, imbecilic monkeys. Oh no. Oh no.
Shush.
Wait for it. Look out! Oh.
Oh.
And as such hurts me, these two are basically muscle-bound versions of Bill and Ted.
Oh my god, they are.
God, you're right.
Wow. Yeah. This is the canonical reason for Meg working for Hades.
Well, not quite. It's more like how he found out about her.
Oh. And you know, it works. Hold on.
Hold on, hold on. I got
Is that Slappy?
I wanna be
Wait, Slappy the Squirrel from Animaniacs?
Yeah. And also, I know him from somewhere else.
Where?
Where?
Squad Cats.
Huh.
Yeah, she's one of the Metallic Cats.
Ah.
Yeah. She wanted to forget Adonis!
Yeah! Ah, oh, Hercules, you dolt.
Whoa!
Ow.
Wow.
Oh boy, here it comes.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Wait for it.
Heads up.
Ah!
Fuck!
Oh,
that is the most serious case of Ace of Blue Balls ever.
Yes.
It explains why it seems it makes it canon.
Yeah. And at least Meg can forget about Adonis now.
No, that's the thing.
Oh. Oh,
It only worked on Hercules.
Yeah.
She does got a point.
Go watch the movie.
Yeah.
That's why I love
it. All right. I'll be honest here, that was actually a really good episode.
Oh, yeah.
And honestly, I know I said it before, it's probably the closest we... Okay, I haven't seen all the episodes of Hercules, but it's probably the closest we've got to a legitimate Greek tragedy.
Yeah.
So... So the two of them basically met, they fell in love with one another, and by the end, they forget they even met.
Mm-hmm. Yet,
one wonders if they ever did remember when they eventually got married.
Probably.
Possibly.
I mean, considering the fact that that episode clearly takes place after... the events of the movie.
Yeah, but here's the thing: just because they eventually met again doesn't mean they remember or how they or that they met before. I mean,
yeah,
or
true.
Hell. When you think about it, there's a chance that might not have happened because, as look at how powerful that water was. It made a thing like an imp forget. Supposedly, this water is so powerful it could make gods forget things.
Yeah.
For all we know, they probably don't even remember this ever happened, even after they got married.
Yeah.
Hey, and okay, granted, it wasn't exactly the greatest way to meet, but the fact that they don't remember their true. Where they first met in terms of true love, that's kind of heartbreaking.
Yeah.
Kind of, yeah.
I mean, yes, they met again and later, but the thing is, the fact that they don't remember that they met before all this, it is a little sad.
Agreed.
It's basically gut-wrenching if you think about it.
Yeah.
It's at least good to know that you know that they eventually do meet again. And in the movies they actually do get together. But still, this ending is not exactly a happy one. And honestly, I give them credit for doing so. Was it done to basically...
Agreed.
Now, yes, this was done to basically, you know, make sure that things were kept canon. But I still feel there was a legitimate attempt to try... Why I tell you a unique story here with Meg and Hercules as teenagers. And honestly, this kind of helps further explain why they have such good chemistry in the movie. They had met before, and it's just basically that a part of them does feel some familiarity towards one another.
Yeah.
Definitely.
This actually further explains why it was that Meg fell in love with Hercules so quickly, because she already had.
Yeah.
Even if they managed to basically remember what happened, thanks to, well... a few sources, but But that's when she could have easily knew that she just loved Herc for the very beginning, no matter what.
Yeah, I do like the. I honestly do like the fact that this episode. Well, it does show that Meg, even back then, was manipulative and even somewhat cruel. At the end of the day, she did still have a soft spot for Hercules. Hercules.
Yeah.
Please, which not only is very heartwarming, and it's accurate to the character.
It is.
And the fact they got Susan Egan to voice her in the series is the icing on the cake, which really makes this feel like a legitimate return of the character.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
And hell, this makes sense as to why she didn't appear again in the series. They couldn't have that happen because they the whole thing with the Amphora.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I give this a solid B+ in terms of an episode.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Oh. It's not the best episode, but it's far from the worst.
It's definitely something more for the fans of the movie who want to see a little bit more about how why it was that Megan and Herc had such good chemistry. History. And you know what, at the end of the day, I think I will keep all the parts of this of the recording. Even if Zero to Hero wasn't what we thought it was. Let's be honest here, at the end of the day, we still enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's gonna do it for this edition of TTR at the Movies, even though we watched a lot of television at the movies. Whatever.
Anyway, still
time for the sign offs.
I have been your flamboyant flyer, Flutter98, saying throw on flyers.
Go ahead, RedRob.
I'm Aka RedRob Ranger, here to remind you that Disney means believing to believe that, well, you gotta. For a true hero is not the measure about the size of his strength, but the strength of, well, you get the rest.
The strength of his dick?
Nice.
Thank you.
I mean,
thank you, deal.
You're welcome.
I mean, come on, podcast, Sentai Master 100, and Herc was so close to getting that kiss.
In the words of Get Smart, missed it by that much.
Yeah.
Anyway. And I, of course, have been your kind, but beloved overlord, real guy, extraordinaire, Diablo 2016, reminding you that I'm just a passing Sir Toku fan. Remember that. Words to the wise folks. Oaks, never try or accept a quest from a girl that has death you get back in Amphora. There might be memories for getting water in it. You forget the whole thing. Let's be fair here, no one wins that way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah. As we've said before, look forward to tomorrow, wherein we'll be going to Hawaii to learn about Ohana. And finally come back again on Friday, where we learn to go to infinity and beyond with Buzz Lightyear.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Anyway.
Yep.
Don't forget to praise our meme goddamn Kuroto. And of course, ciao. We will see you all next time, folks. Have a good night and take care. Bye!
Later.
See ya.